Hey, all right. Hey, everybody, welcome. Perfect timing. Hi, Luz. Welcome to the stream. Hope you're doing well. You were just fucking ready for that one. All right. I guess that's my welcome back after all the after this past week. How you doing, bud? Welcome. Hope you're doing well. How are you, bud? You're not sorry about that. Don't you lie to me. Don't you fucking lie to me. But how are you? Doing good? Happy to hear it. Welcome. Actually, I'm glad to be back. I keep taking breaks. It's not on purpose that I keep taking breaks, but wow. Oh, that was quick. All right. Hold on a second. Ooh, it looks like the bots missed me too. That's crazy. Hold on a second. Anyway. Alright then. Wow, I was expecting at least like half an hour in to get one of those, but alright. Sure. Yeah, bot really missed me on that one. Jesus Christ. Anyway, I've been itching to fucking play this since I picked it up last stream, so I'm just gonna go for it. Just make sure to perk up the volume a little bit more. There we go, and screw it. Let's play some fucking Disco Elysium, baby! Woo! I'm excited. This is gonna be a departure from my usual games that I play, because I'm playing this one with one hand. It's a point and click, and it's really funny, and I'm almost dead. And I have one pip of mental health left. I've been getting my ass kicked. Alright then. What other hand do? Other hand, try to stay warm, because it's cold as fuck in here. How you doing, Capty? Welcome to
Stream. Before you stands a motor carriage. The bodywork is covered in blue and white livery, bearing the number 57.
Can I just say how much I love that narrator voice? It's mwah, sublime.
Vapor emanates from the large engine on the back of the vehicle. It hasn't had time to cool off yet.
Open the door. What's in there?
In the cabin, you are welcomed by a set of steering levers, a radio microphone on a hook, a pull-out toolbox under the seat, and the soft glow.
It tries to stay warm. Preheat
gauge.
Yeah, it tries to stay warm. It's fucking cold in here. Actually, hold on a second. I'm actually curious. What is the current temperature? I don't know if you can even hear that. Oh, there you go. What is the current temperature? It's 9 degrees Celsius. What is 9 degrees Celsius in Fahrenheit?
9 degrees Celsius is equivalent to 48.2 degrees Fahrenheit.
There you go. That's your Americanized, shittier version. That's how cool it is. Yeah, there you go, Americans, you bunch of fucking nerds.
A scent of leatherwork and heavy fuel oils washes over you.
Ooh, I love the smell of leatherwork. Pick up the radio.
The tableau lights up, and a green button labeled Prime Line glows like a feline eye. And then you hear something.
Oh, hold on. You say it's like spring. Okay. All right, hold on. I forgot to mention the other part. What is the current humidity?
The current humidity in Hameran is 87%.
Yeah, shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. Wuss? Fucking. Alright, what's yours, forehead?
The soft purr of electrical kittens. Radio waves cast far and wide over the metropolis. A woman's voice greets you through the static.
The soft purr of electrical kittens. Fahrenheit, I don't even know her. That almost works, Luce. There's a joke there somewhere. We can work on that.
This is Precinct 57. Hello, Lieutenant. How may I assist you?
Lieutenant? That's very French.
Hello, Alice. Please assist our colleague from the 41st Precinct here. I'm putting him on.
It's 30 degrees here. In Celsius, you'd be like summer right there. That doesn't make any fucking sense. Yeah, but what's your humidity? Tell me about your humidity and how much lower than 87% it is.
Operating the radio is easy. Just be confident. You've probably done it 1,000 times.
Okay. Hi, Alice. This is the officer from the 41st Precinct speaking. Nice to meet you.
This is Officer Alice Demetri, Precinct 57. How may I assist you?
Isn't that 0 Celsius? Fuck Fahrenheit. Fahrenheit's dumb. I said it here first. Fahrenheit's dumb. Learn Celsius.
Under the green prime line, a yellow saved button catches your eye. You wonder what the lieutenant's default radio station is.
Ignore Alice and press the button labeled saved. Ooh, I could. Later. I could sync off that later. Right now, I want to talk to, Oh, yeah, because I lost my fucking badge. Okay, hold on. I gotta remember, can I access my task list? Okay, yeah, here's my tasks that I gotta do for today. Yeah, here it is. Phone failed to update the weather, says 29 degrees Fahrenheit humidity. 27! Shut your ass up. 27. 27. It's like a mildly cold wind. Yeah, get the fuck out of here. The air is... There's condensation on... Oh, God, that's actually really cold. Jesus. It's like a freezer in here. All right. So what am I doing? I gotta find booze. I gotta look at the murder body. I gotta report my missing badge. Pay for damages. What was it like $100? I gotta find and smoke cigarettes. Find out who the Sylvie person is. Sing karaoke and get a reality lowdown. It was snowing yesterday's. Oh, look at me. Here I am, living over in a state where weird white shit rains down from the heavens and makes everything really super slippery. Oh, just show off. Fucking show off. No one's impressed. No one's fucking impressed. Little show off over here, showing off. Could you connect me to the 41st? I have something I need to report, namely my missing fucking badge.
Just a second, officer.
Puts you on hold, the static crackling softly like a bonfire. After a while, you hear an old man greet you from the radio. His rattly voice is oddly familiar.
10-2, 10-5, this is 41st, come in, over.
Hi, this is me here. I work at your station. Context. When the game started, I woke up with a hangover that literally gave me amnesia. I got that shit-faced that I actually have no idea who I am or where I am.
10-4, what's your status? Over.
It's not good.
10-18, 10-20, over.
Please just talk human to me. These numbers mean nothing to me.
State your message, sir. Over.
How's all your ocean? It's very salty. I haven't seen it in a while. I would assume it's still salty. I'm in dire need of financial assistance. God, yes.
10-4, I hear you. I don't have the authority to grant your request, but...
Is it him? What does he want?
Oh.
He says he needs money.
I do need money.
Don't give that asshole anything. He's just gonna drink it all.
Well, fuck you, Jean. You don't know me. I don't know me. I'm a new me.
Right. That's a negative on the additional funds, sir. Over.
Motherfucker. Is it the flock of cranes thriving? Oh, I just got that. It's actually been a hot second since I've seen one of those. I gotta be honest. I haven't seen too many of those. I don't even have places. It is paramount to the investigation that you grant me more money.
He says it's important to the case.
He isn't getting a red cent. You can tell him that.
Request denied, sir. Over.
Nothing is working.
Nothing is working. Please, I don't even have a place to sleep tonight.
He says he's in trouble. Doesn't have a place to sleep.
Well, I guess he'd better crack the case before sundown, then.
Wigmar said...
I don't even want to be here anymore. I want to go home. Please come and get me.
Listen. It's okay. You can do it, sir.
No!
What is he saying?
Did you want anything else, sir? Many of your colleagues are also here. Over.
Please, no one be here.
He terminated the connection. I guess he was in a hurry.
Please, I'm scared. I can't breathe. Help me, please. Shit.
The radio falls silent and lifeless. The communications officer has disconnected the call.
I got myself mental damage and he fucking hung up on me.
What was that? It's okay, detective.
Oh my god, I'm gonna die so fucking fast. You never seen a man get a panic attack before? We call it some diffusion of force ever heard of it. Wipe away tears. That's the one. That's the one.
We should get on with our tasks. Work always helps me center myself. Now, anything else you need from my vehicle, or...?
Well, give me the toolbox.
The metallic drawer slides out from under the seat and clicks into place.
Uh-huh.
The tools inside are neatly organized.
Mm-hmm.
Take what you need, officer. It's going to be a long case. I'm not protective of my tools, like some men are.
Okay, well, what you
He's
got
He's clearly a little protective of his tools. But what can you do? Work is work.
Work is work. Well, we're gonna need the pry bar.
The pry bar feels nice and cold in your hand.
Ooh.
Heavier than you'd think.
Good.
Cold and heavy, like truth. You feel like you're reunited with truth once more.
Nothing like cold, hard truth. For pacifying criminals.
Useful for opening all sorts of doors and lids.
Give me the chain cutters.
The handles are long and sleek. Snap, snap, go the cutters in your hand.
Fuck yeah.
You can do good work with these. Cut chains, locks, and ropes, especially belts.
And we're gonna need this flashlight.
It's robust, weatherproof, and well-made. Police issue, blue. Lets you see things in the dark you would otherwise miss.
Mm-hmm. Hell yeah.
The toolbox slides back into its nest. Preheater gauge casts a warm glow on the steering levers and the radio on its hook.
Give me the radio again, actually.
This is Precinct 57. How may I assist you?
Yeah, this is Sylvie. Maybe it would help.
What is her number, officer?
Yeah, Kim, didn't Cart give you Sylvie's number?
Yes, hold on.
Oh, thank God.
The number is 005-1944-298.
Received. Hold on, officer.
Start slapping a marching rhythm on your thighs. That's what I do when I'm on hold. You start hand-boning.
Give it a minute. She might be busy at the moment. Takes a bit to get to the phone.
This game is so relatable.
Officer?
Oh.
I have Sylvie Malaika on the line for you.
Hell yeah.
Yes, hello?
Female voice greets you to static. Sounds like she's a million miles away from here. This is the police calling. I have some questions for you about your last days of work.
Oh, right. Hello, officer. What can I do for you?
There is no resentment in her tone. She wants you to ask her out. No question about it.
We're in. Ooh, last one. That's gonna be the last question, though. I don't want to fuck up the case. Hold on. You quit your job at the Whirling. Why?
You mean, why did I leave the bar? Honestly, I'm not really comfortable discussing it with you, sir.
Why aren't you comfortable discussing it with me?
Let's just say I left because I needed to get away from someone.
Get away from whom?
You know whom.
I don't. Amnesia, you do that? I really don't. You come back to work?
Maybe, I don't know. I just know I have to take some time off right now.
Was it you who called the police?
No, not me.
Didn't the curse at your workplace bother you? Yeah, why didn't you?
What? Of course it bothered me. But I thought the union already knew about the court.
What does this union have to do with anything?
No one calls the police. The union would get angry.
What do you mean by that?
You know, what the union says goes. People listen to them and they take care of their own, which is like everyone here.
I am the authority right here. I am the authority around here. Fucking, I'm a super cop.
Okay.
She obviously doesn't want to challenge your authority. You feel much better now. Tell me, why exactly did you let a corpse hang in your own backyard for weeks instead of calling us?
I didn't want to get in trouble with the others.
Push her further. Show her the error of her ways.
Let me get this straight. You ignored the law to save your own skin?
I didn't know I had to report it. I thought someone would take him down eventually.
The fucking nerves on her. Trying to hide behind weakness. You're a god. An angry but just god.
I'm a god. You report to me, not to the... Is that clear? Oh no. Oh yeah, I'm doing that one. I'm a god. You report to me, not to the union. Is it clear?
Hey, if you cannot restrain yourself, then I'll be handling the interviews from now on, and you can quietly take notes.
You got your methods, I got mine, Lieutenant. Let me do my job.
Fine. But know that I don't approve of such gratuitous volatility.
Yeah, whatever.
Kevin. Breathing on the other end suggests that Sylvie is still on the line.
Do you know who
she
made that call?
Everything.
Yeah, do you know who made that call?
No. I honestly don't know.
Uh-huh.
It was someone else. We'll find them sooner or later, officer. It just might take a while.
Okay, next question.
Okay.
Hey, you wanna grab a cup of coffee with me? Oh, fuck.
Despair creeps into you.
Uh-oh.
Getting fat on your weakness.
Uh-oh.
Whatever noble intentions you once had as a police officer, it's eating them all up now.
Oh, no.
You're still coming up with sentences. That's a step up from total annihilation, right?
I'm just shisting him like corpses hang on trees. But I wasted my life protecting humans. Oh, no. Oh, shit.
Fuck me? Please leave the rage you have for after we finish the investigation.
Nothing you can say would make you feel any better now.
Oh god, I think I'm dead.
Cop gives up the detective genre for social realism. Another police officer resigned from the RCM following a nervous breakdown. He now lives under a bridge, drinking and occasionally throwing excrement at passers-by, shouting, I never loved that woman. When asked to comment, former colleagues objected to the theory that his psychological disintegration was precipitated by his wife leaving him. It's because the Furrows lost that match, said Captain Ptolemy Price, once the man's superior officer. It's because he couldn't get a big gun from acquisitions.
Oh no.
And anyway, police work really burns you out after a while. Satellite officer Jean-Vic Meyer, the deranged former cop's partner, commented. Sergeant Matt Torson, another former colleague, did not propose any theories, merely saying, whatever happened to him wasn't about birds. He got fucked, that's all.
Oh. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Alright, fine, we'll go back. Okay, note to self, don't get a woman to break up with you. They really push you over the edge. Alright, kids? Kids, you're taking notes, right?
Vapor emanates. In the cabin, you are welcomed by a set of steering levers, a radio mug, a scent of leather, a metallic drill.
Take what you need.
He's clearly the bribe, cold, useful for opening doors, the handles. You can do good. It's robust. Lets you see. The pull-out toolbox slides back into its nest. Preheat the frequency. The soft.
Let me get this out of the way.
Hello, Alice.
Operating the radio.
This is
under the green prime line. A yellow.
Dr. Sylvie.
What is an
Yes.
Received. Hold on.
Lieutenant Kitsuragi slowly begins.
Officer? Yes. Hello.
Sylvie, I believe we've met before. This is me, a detective from the Whirling and Rags.
Oh, right. Hello, officer. What can I...
There is no resentment in her tone. She wants you to...
Yeah, that's
Maybe
actually...
Why did I leave the bar? Maybe, I don't know.
Oh, fuck. No, I misclicked.
No, absolutely not.
That came so fast, you can't but wonder what else she would be good at.
Yes, what would she be good at?
Baseball, ring a bell quiz shows, catching keys in the air, petting an angry cat.
Yeah, probably.
No, not me.
Do you know who made that call?
Sorry.
No.
People don't have the money to have the cables put in again.
Oh.
They use the union's phone, or the one on the coast.
Not a lot of people have phones around here. Copper thieves take the wires.
It was someone else. We'll find them sooner.
Yeah,
okay, fair enough.
Go on. I do hope so. Please, don't call me again. Bye.
Yeah, why is she angry with me?
Yes, you have obviously done something to upset her at the Whirling in Rags when she was still working there.
Wait, before you go, you're mad at me, right? Tell me, what did I do? I can't remember anything.
I'm not mad, it's just... You were so drunk and so emotional all the time, and then the scooter thing happened. It just made me want to quit.
What scooter thing?
The stuffed bird. The great scooter. You threw it against the wall while screaming, fuck that bird, and laughing like a maniac.
That does sound like a me thing. Alright, to be honest, that's real. That does sound like a me thing. I would do that. That's fair.
I think you said it had been giving you shit ever since you got there.
Giving you shit. That sounds like me, alright. That's not anything like me. I love birds. Bitch, bird got what's going to do. God damn it, they're all good options. Oh, fuck's sake. This sounds like me, alright.
Didn't seem like you had fun doing it, though.
You telling me I was the one who made you quit?
Yes, obviously. You were the worst client I've ever seen.
Oh.
And I have seen so many assholes in this place.
Oh.
I've had sailors fighting, union guys grabbing my ass, kids stealing booze. Once a guy was glued to the karaoke machine every night for 2 months. But you...
Go on.
Well, you were worse than all of them. Honestly, you were getting borderline aggressive. Even about little things like not turning down the volume at 3 a.m. I even liked one of those songs you kept listening to on repeat. No more. I hate it now.
Hold on, which song?
We Go On by the O.O. I can't listen to it anymore. You've turned it into a parody.
Sorry. I'm sorry about the song.
To hell with that song. Then there was your room. Your project. An experiment to see how bad it can get in there. I tried to send the cleaner, but you wouldn't let me. Threatened to make me understand. I had no idea what you meant, and I don't want to know. And then screamed something about how you're a piece of shit human being, and why does anyone even let you work as a policeman? That you'd fire yourself, but you can't even do that.
That's a bit. I'm sorry.
And then I had to deal with your toilet.
Oh no.
The one you clogged with police documents,
oh,
causing
shit.
Water damage downstairs in the kitchen.
Oh shit.
I won't even mention you waving your gun around, harassing customers, threatening to sing karaoke, threatening to kill yourself.
Wait, police documents?
The ones I had to rent out of your toilet.
What happened to them?
I don't remember what I did to your damn papers. I don't remember every little thing I do.
All right, fair.
She's worried she might have accidentally done something bad. Then she remembers it's you.
Cool.
Especially when there's a hurricane loose. It's your fault for losing them, not mine.
Something in you wants to immediately forget about this, as if there was a reason you threw them away.
Okay, I get it. I wasn't a very good tenant.
No, you really weren't. You were simply the worst.
I was trying to show you the world of tomorrow, the great panic at the worst heaven which I've ever seen. No! No, I am truly sorry for everything, Sylvie.
God, I know I shouldn't have brought it up. Just try not to call me again, and let's pretend it never happened.
What else did I sing beside you? Oh, I'm looking for a song.
Oh, all sorts of things. From disco, rock too. So much disco and rock.
Was I singing The Smallest Church in Saint-Saëns?
That's the one you like to sing along to the most. The later it got, the more that one came on.
Interesting. You still have to find a copy, though, before you can blast it.
That's for karaoke. I still gotta sing that shit. Thank you for talking with me. Take care.
You hear a sigh of relief on the other end of the radio. Wordless, the call breaks. Then, the already familiar voice.
Anything else I can help you with, officer?
No, I want to press the save button.
As always, it's DJ Mesh and Fellatio, and you're listening to Street Freaks FM, bringing you the hottest, the nastiest, the most vulgar.
A flock of seagulls takes off nearby, startled by the roaring radio. Right away, the lieutenant reaches into the cabin and turns off the radio. He's not looking at you. As he says,
someone must have been messing with the radio, or maybe picked up a random frequency. You wanted a prime line, right?
Speed Freaks of FM, huh? Huh, Kim? Speed Freaks of FM.
Oh, is that what it was called?
He's trying hard to act surprised. Kim, buddy!
Go for it. Turn the radio back on while it's still on the Speed Freaks FM.
Pick up the radio again.
Souped up motor carriage for one bad mama's boy. For the heavier foot and the freaky M.
Freaky M.
God damn it.
The lieutenant moves quick as a viper as he switches off the radio and sets it on prime line. Then he turns to you.
Look, it helps me to stay alert on long nights, okay? It's a method. I'm not some kind of speed freak or...
He shakes his head, fiercely staring at his feet. What about heavy of foot?
You would be too if you had this motor carriage.
Oh.
But seriously, let's quit joking around, alright? We have a case to investigate.
This is Precinct 57. Can I connect you to someone?
No, I'm good.
57's over and out.
Thank you.
In the cabin, you see a set of steering levers. The white suede feels luxurious under the touch.
Ooh.
And the metal clutch handle so very familiar in your palm.
Ooh, tap on the fuel preheater gauge.
As you tap on the gauge, the indicator pin jerks as if startled. It's in the large orange sector, indicating the engine is warm. Next to the gauge is a red switch labeled heat.
There's no use pressing the heat button. It won't start without the ignition key.
Alternative translation. Don't even think you can drive my MC.
Damn it. Kim, what are we looking at? What is this machine?
This is the Cupris Kinema, my motor carriage. You can use the toolbox and the radio if you'd like.
Okay, but what is a motor carriage?
A motorized vehicle, officer. I'm sure you are familiar with the concept. We've had these for nearly a century.
This'll never catch on. Do all policemen in the RCM have such cool motor carriages?
The Cupris Motor Corps does provide most of our patrol vehicles, yes.
Yeah.
But this is different. This is a sports model.
I might be wrong, but this one is a sports model, right?
You're right. I didn't take you for a motor car enthusiast. Do you also like Tip Top, detective?
What's Tip Top?
An interinsulary racing series. You should definitely give it a go if you like motor carriages.
Oh.
It has fantastic competition.
You could race? Our race? Ooh. Okay.
In the cabin, you see a set.
All right, I'm done here for the moment. You didn't actually close the door.
All around you, rain falls on the great city of Rivershaw. Rain drips from the eaves and floods the gutters, washing the filth away. The spring thaw must be here. The snow is melting.
What am I doing?
Looking up at the sky, cold water dripping from your hair.
What do I see?
Gray sky like great battleships, clouds colliding with one another. Rain falls down on the world.
How does it feel?
Your shirt sticks to your chest. The shoulders of your disco blazer grow heavy. The cold finds its way in under your skin. You shiver, and the city shivers with you.
Ooh.
You're not dressed for this weather. You should get an overcoat or a patrol cloak.
What is in the west?
Sheets of rain over the water. A flight of stairs leading into the ocean. Mm-hmm. Wave after wave washing the coast of Martinez, with its motorboats and gently swaying reeds.
That's a really nice image, actually.
The ruins of a half-sunken sea fort crumble on an inlet beyond the Bay of Rivershaw. Ghosts rise into the sky.
Who are you, ghosts?
The skyscrapers of La Delta, the financial district. Faint golden light seeps from the office windows.
This writing is so good, holy shit. What is down the shore?
Urban coastline, rain dripping off Eternite covered roofs. Cinder blots left over from half finished construction. A defunct research and development building, once seized by revolutionaries. An old wooden church stands on stilts above the water.
And beyond that?
Coal City. End of all lines.
Oof. Run your fingers through your dampened hair.
Your hair is an oily mess flecked with ash from neighboring coal plants.
No!
Smokestacks rise somewhere in the distance.
What's in the east?
There's a fleet on the corner. A plastic coat is folded into a small triangle under the counter by the window. Beyond that, the strikebreakers have gathered.
Strikebreakers?
The great gates of the industrial harbor are locked. A chill runs down your back. You shudder like an animal trying to shake water from its hide.
Clench your teeth to stop shuddering. Cold can't take me.
Heaps of supply crates, red and blue metal shipping containers, slick with rain. The Greater Rivershaw Industrial Harbor is an artificial mountain range. Immense wealth resides within. And immeasurable poverty in its shadow.
And beyond that?
La Jussienne, King Dri's passenger harbor. Cruise ships flanked by dock arms. Cranes watching over the mouth of the river distributary.
What is across the distributary?
Couron, the lower middle class. Distributary after distributary cuts the city blocks in half. Seven-story buildings trail off into the rain.
What is beyond the Couron?
A silvery curtain of rain over the houses. The class divide.
Okay. But the north?
Capeside apartments. Tower blocks crowd one another. 4.46mm bullets still lodged in their war-torn stone walls.
Jesus.
Hallways collapse from the mortar hits of a war that was lost long ago. Clotheslines go to waste in the rain. Radios play.
And closer to here?
A yard. Rain falls onto the roof of a woodshed. Coal leaks into a puddle beneath a dead man's feet. He swings from a tree, bloated. Droplets of rain slip from his cold cheeks.
In the south.
A traffic jam. Rain thrumming on the roofs of motor vehicles. Inside, drivers watch water streaming down their windshields. The statue of a king shudders. He too is cold. The canal bridge has been raised.
What's on the other side?
The road ascends. A raised motorway loops above the ghetto. Beneath its concrete columns, a sea of rooftops, woodwork, and tar stretches northward. Four-story buildings as far as the rain can fall. The snows melt in Jamrock.
What is Jamrock?
Revachol is the capital of the world. Jamrock is the capital of Revachol. Droplets form on your eyelashes. It's home.
Have a brother in the cut. Where the wood at?
Shut the fuck up. Why am I not there?
To be in Martinez, where no one goes, at the runoff point of a long forgotten canal, in the whitest part of town, in the shadow of the day the revolution failed.
What am I doing here?
Standing in the rain, looking north, where Jamrock Rock City stretches inland.
Further.
In the rain-swept distance, above the rooftops of Jamrock, a repurposed silk mill stands perched above the motorway exit. Precinct 41 hunches in the rain. It's the only home you have now, but you can't go back. Not like this. Your vision blurs. You wipe your face with your hand. The rain stings your eyes, making you look up and blink.
What's above?
Coalition era statics hang like apparitions under the cloud cover. Way up there, where rain forms, rotors flutter silently. Your sight clears.
Motherfucker.
This rain will not let up anytime soon. You should get a raincoat. There's a freight to the east. They sell them there.
Guess I'm getting a raincoat? Ooh, autosave. Thank God. A heap of snow melts in this wheelbarrow. The street sign reads, fuck the police. This the freight? God, there's so much to do and so much to look at in this fucking game. Jesus Christ. What about this one? Pigs go home. The street name is illegible. I tell you what, we should actually like go take that body down that we've been actually here to do the actual.
You see a set of tire tracks in the brown slush that covers the plaza mosaic.
Reconstruct the movement. I could try.
No, these tracks are not interesting at all. Let the street sweeper just sweep them away.
Damn. Why am I looking at this?
Cop habit. You look at everything.
What kind of vehicle drove through here?
Hard to say. Your vision is blurred and you're having difficulty concentrating thanks to your relentless hangover.
Checks out. All right then. Where's the body? There it is. Jesus. Smells like spoiled meat and curdled dairy. A human being decomposes. Someone's trying to grow herbs in this greenhouse. This kid's ladder is rickety but still climbable. What are you shit kids doing here? This is a crime scene.
Kuno's got this.
The boy throwing rocks at a dead body can't be older than 12.
Oh yeah, Nappa Goofy Kuno!
Hey kid, a word. Police business.
Right in the dick, Kuno! Get him right in the dick!
Oh, Jesus.
Love it in the dick.
Alright, buddy.
The boy is sweating profusely. His eyes are like two black holes and his jaw is twitching as if trying to break free from the empire of his body.
Hold on, what does that mean?
The kid is obviously high.
Cool. Stop using slurs on my crime scene. That's not how we do it.
Can't talk, pig. Shit's coming up strong. Throwing rocks.
Shit coming up strong. That sounds good. Joyous.
Ugh.
You should hang out with this kid and see what that juicy shit is all about.
You might be in the know.
Yeah, Kuno! Ride the lightning, Kuno!
Kuno's riding it, see?
He wipes sweat from his brow and sends another rock flying.
The rake, Kuno! You should throw the rake at him, Kuno!
The fuck does Kuno know what a rake is? Kuno's not a gardener.
You know what a rake is?
Goddamn right he's not a gardener. He's an athlete. Every rock connects, making the battered corpse look just a little bit worse for wear.
Kid, you want to hang out? I'm not an arc.
Fuck no. Oh. Kuno doesn't buy that shit. Fucking entrapment shit.
Damn it, he's too smart for his chat.
Fast. This kid has got street smarts.
Damn it. Are you kid siblings?
The fuck are you talking about?
He's calling us f***ed, Kuno. He says we're fucking each other.
No. No. I got some questions
right
for you.
Entertain the Kuno. Show me what you got. What you got there? What you got, huh? Show me what you got.
The kid moves his hands like a basketball player dribbling fast.
The body. What do you know about it?
Shitload, pig. What's your question?
Don't tell the pig shit, Kuno!
This is where you quickly ask him questions. Real cop questions. Like a cop.
Do you know who he was?
Kuno's fuckimp. Kuno uses the fuckimp for target practice.
A fuckimp. That's the one.
He could have just said he doesn't know.
You could have just said you don't know.
Kuno knows shit. Kuno's not a snitch. That's all. Trying to make Kuno sing into the popo phone.
Do you know how he got up there?
Probably climbed. Kuno was busy down the road when that shit went down.
So you didn't see it happening?
You heard Kuno. Kuno wasn't even in Martinez. Kuno wasn't in Revachol. Kuno wasn't regional.
Oh, okay. Where'd you go then?
I don't know. Some fucking...
He looks around trying to come up with something.
Mesk or I don't know. Some other place. Night City. Kuno is in fucking Night City.
Where's Night City?
Kuno gives this info out on a need-to-know basis, and you don't need to know. Kuno didn't smoke the gimp, if that's what you meant.
He might have. He might have. I don't trust this shit, kid. Have you seen anyone suspicious around?
Just a couple of pigs sniffing around in the dirt. That seems pretty fucking suspicious to Kuno.
Hey, wait a minute. That's us. Wait a goddamn second.
You tell the faggoty, Kuno.
More on this later. Right now, let's talk about something else.
You're testing Kuno's patience, yeah?
I'll beat the shit out of you, kid.
Get lost,
About the crime scene, you kids often play in this yard?
Right, pig. This is where Kuno plays with his little wooden choo-choo. What the fuck do you want with it?
That ladder yours?
No, it's not fucking Kuno's. It's ancient. Look at it.
He thinks you're fucking fool, Kuno. He says you climb the ladder up to your magic tree house.
Oh my god. I fucking hate these two.
Get the fuck out of here, pig. Kuno doesn't have a magic tree house.
What's in the greenhouse over there?
Dunno. Kiptas gardener used to work there.
Hold on, the gardener used to work there?
Yeah, that's what Kuno said. She couldn't handle the heat, so she took off. Kuno can take it. Shit, nothing to Kuno.
Okay, what do you mean by kipped?
Look it up in the library. Kuno's not a fucking dictionary. Fucking small brain. Kuno means the gardener, all right?
Would you fucking insult me? You shit kid. You mean the young woman by whirling in rags? That gardener?
Look, Kuno doesn't explain shit. Kuno just says shit.
You do just say shit. Let's talk about something else.
Yeah, whatever. Kuno doesn't give a shit.
I gotta ask, who's Kuno anyway?
Kuno's Kuno Pig?
Just doing one of these? Okay. Alright.
Kuno. Primal. Violent.
Ugh. Sounds like something you'd call a rabid dog.
Yeah, think about it. Think about that rabid Kuno shit.
Watch out, Kuno, he's trying to fiddle you. He's gonna put his hands on you.
The thing behind the fence starts squealing. It's actually like piercing my ears a little bit. I'm not gonna lie, this fucking voice.
Help, pig's got Kuno. Help, rape.
Jeez. All right.
Help, he's got the Kuno, help.
What the fuck?
Everyone can hear. You need to get the hell out of here before.
I'm not doing anything.
Everybody, please. He's digging his dick out.
Escalate, Kuno. His dick is out. You're afraid.
Pigs are there in Kuno. Somebody, please.
Oh, Christ. Full blast now. The wind carries the message far and wide across Martinez.
Look at his shit-eating grin. He knows there's nothing you can do to him. He's bullying you, and you are helpless. Kill him. Kill him now. He won't see death coming.
Can I save? I would have saved, like, right the fuck now. Oh, no, I can't. Please let me save. No. Wait, but I could get a point in something, looks like. How many points do I have? Just the one, I guess. Let's see. Raw intellectual power. Fascinating trivia. The art of persuasion. Play the actor, lie and detect lies. That could be a good one. Reconstruct crime scenes. Let's do drama. Oh, can I do more? What if we do visual calculus? Or I can't. I think I only got the 1 point. That's fine. Oh, I'm beating the shit out of this kid. Fuck it. Let's do it. Oh, no. Ah! No! Oh, shit!
You didn't shut him down. Your fat fist didn't meet its target.
Oh, no.
Instead, it pulled you down with it.
Fetch my arm and my fucking knee.
Kuno can't believe this shit. Can no one stop the Kuno? Pig, Kuno thought you had this.
Oh, no.
What happened? Kuno can't do anything now.
He's writhing with joy like the power you gave him is too much to take. Oh, God, I made him worse. Uh-oh.
Despair creeps into you.
God damn it.
Getting fat. On your weakness. Whatever noble intentions you once had as a police officer, it's eating them all up now.
Fuck.
You're still coming up with sentences. That's a step up from total annihilation, right?
I don't dispute that you have been charged with protecting the people of a particularly challenging district. But poverty does not make one a loser. Poverty is just poverty.
My morale's too low for this shit.
Nothing you can say would make you feel any better now. Cop gives up the God detective genre for...
Alright, again, goddammit. I can do it. I can do it. I can be a great detective. Is there a quick save button? I need to find out if there's a quick save button. Yeah, that's that. That's fine. And that coordination's up all the way. What could I do? I think drama still, yeah. Yeah, that's fine. Where's the, is there really no, like, character? Oh, here we go. F5 is quick save. Okay, got it. So, F5. Now let's get this bastard.
Kuno's got this!
Oh yeah! Nappa Goofy, Kuno!
Can't talk, pig! Shit's coming up strong!
Uh-huh.
Shit coming up strong.
Juicy I mean drugs.
Yeah, Kuno! Ride the lightning, Kuno!
Kuno's right!
The rake, Kuno! You should ride
the fuck!
Goddamn right he's not a gardener. He's an athlete. Every rock can-
The fuck?
He's calling us Kuno!
What? You wanna fuck Kuno now?
No.
That's it. That's all you've got. No. Got your ass handed to you by the Kuno.
Swaying from side to side like a vicious rooster. Can I punch him again?
Who's the man now, huh? Kuno's the man. You wouldn't believe the pussy Kuno tears up.
Oh, okay, buddy.
What was that, Kuno?
Nothing, see. Nothing. Just slicing some bacon.
Yeah, was that Kuno, huh? Yeah, that's what I fucking thought, Kuno. I'm not an arc.
No.
Fast. This kid has got street smarts.
All right.
The kid moves his hands like...
Yeah, who's Kuno? This dude's kid.
Primal.
You refer violent. To yourself in the third person?
The fuck are you calling a third person? Kuno's the fucking first person?
Of course.
Watch out, Kuno! He's trying to help! Pig,
uh-huh. Here we go, here we go.
Everyone can hear.
Everybody...
Escalate!
Pigs are hitting Kuno! Somebody...
Look at his shit-eating grin. He knows there's nothing you can do to him. He's bullying you, and you are helpless. Kill him.
58%.
Kill him now.
I can kill him now.
He won't see death coming.
Yes, that's a green. Fuck it. Bitch. There we go. Fuck you.
The blow connects surprisingly well, even your knuckles tingling. Kuno feels it. This was no light tap.
Yeah, fuck you, Kuno.
What?
Everybody call I don't know what got into me. You made me do this. You did this to yourself. We can have a normal conversation now, yeah?
Officer, this is very far from normal police conduct. Get yourself together.
I know what I'm doing, Kim.
Okay, pig.
Something happened. The punch made them calmer. Oh, yeah.
Kuno knows to respect that violent shit.
Uh-huh.
You should see Kuno's dad. Kuno's dad doesn't give a shit about anything.
See, Kim, that right there is good fucking police work. You just pop him one, do it good, don't fuck it up. It'll be great. It'll be fantastic, even. All right.
The creature behind the fence has fallen ominously silent.
Mm-hmm.
Only her eyes are alive, jumping from actor to actor.
Okay, pig. Talk to Kuno. We're back in this shit. The fuck do you want?
See, empathy legendary. Figure out what's going on with this kid. Ooh. I should talk to him more, actually. You respect
You're
me now?
You're dreaming, pig. That's not how this shit works.
A little. But don't expect anything to change.
Hmm.
Don't let him dominate you, Kuno! Fuck his fat ass!
Shitload, pig.
Don't tell the...
This is where you quickly ask him questions. Real
Kuno... Yeah, let me
he could have just said he doesn't know.
Kuno knows shit, probably.
Didn't see it happening. Where'd you
go? I don't know. Mesko. Kuno gives this in just a couple of...
Yeah, you tell the faggoty, Kuno!
You're testing Kuno's pay...
Get lost,
Right, pig. This is where Kuno plays with his little... Yeah, whatever. Kuno doesn't give a shit.
8%? Fuck it.
He's on your crime scene, bossing you around. And he's been here for some time, too. This is where he hangs out. You have to get more out of him.
Kuno, listen. Kuno, listen. I know this boundary pushing thing is new to you, but it's old news for us grown-ups. Hey, Kuno, think you could turn to Kuno down for a moment? Let's talk like normal people. Yeah, let's say the second one.
Get your snout out of Kuno's ass. Kuno knows how hard Kuno pushes it. Kuno pushes it hard level. You should give up, Popo, or the Kun will keep fucking it out of you.
No.
You okay, Kuno?
The Kun has her confused.
That went wrong. He took it as a compliment. Then he had a minor seizure.
Okay, cool. I'm off.
Kuno doesn't fucking care.
Cool. All right. What about you?
Kuno, the pig's getting pretty close to me. Come to snuff my shit out, I think.
Take one step closer.
Looks like it's time for me to go, Kuno. Pig's come to take me in.
She means it. The fear is real.
I just want to ask you some questions.
I'm going away for a long, long time, Kuno. Going away for life.
What's going on there? Fuck are you trying to pull, pig?
Child, converse with me.
Murder was the case. Was the case they gave me.
She almost vanished behind the fence. Only the top of her hat remains. Alright, so she's not gonna talk. Fair, I guess. Right, so this
the
body
looks at you with bulging white eyes.
Uh-huh.
The face around them does not look human. It's swollen and ready to burst. His lips are fish-like and his tongue like a ball gag in his mouth. You seem to be holding your breath.
Look down.
A cargo belt twists his neck at an unnatural angle. The body below appears stiff. It's letting out an ungodly rot. The smell seeps in even through your clenched nostrils.
3% spring rods.
The smell is repulsive. It pushes in from your mouth, more instant and more familiar than anything you'd expected. More fever than odor. It fills your mind, flushing you from within.
Let it out. Just do it. That might actually soak me up a little bit, to be honest. There we go. That's good.
You feel a great force ringing from your stomach. Your body curls and pushes it out, burst by burst, until a pool of vomit lies under your feet and your throat stings from the stomach acid.
Not really need a drink.
The smell of Commodore Red rises from the pool. Among it, distilled spirit and bits of shish kebab.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. Happens to everyone. Keep it.
Thanks.
The hangover is clearly making these worse for you. You could use some ammonia to clear your head.
You think ammonia would help?
If you can handle the headache. Some officers use it to deal with cadaverine odor.
But not you.
I can't handle the headache.
Oh.
It's more likely he can handle the smell. Unlike you.
Okay, where do we get ammonia from?
There is Frit nearby, east of the hostel. They usually have a small apothecary. If they don't...
He points to the greenhouse.
There's a greenhouse here, and a gardener with a wheelbarrow on the corner of the whirling in rags. If she works here, she might have something for the smell.
Hmm.
Acquiring ammonia will provide a modifier to the white check.
No.
Modifiers make checks easier and allow you to retry them.
Okay. God, what is that? Why is it so bad?
Active decay. It's okay to throw up, officer. No one is judging.
I already did that, Kim.
He's about to blow! Cop's gonna blow, Kuno!
Hey, so we've been monitoring you internally, and now we know your Kopo type.
There are Kopo types?
Yes. Guess what's yours?
Some kind of weapon cop.
No. You're the sorry cop.
Oh.
The cop who's sorriest. Let's make it official then, shall we?
What are the other Kopo types?
Oh, you know. Apocalypse, Superstellar, the Advanced Interesting Cop, Liquid Shadow Cop. But you're too sorry to say those things. So, here we go.
I want to be an Apocalypse cop. Or a Superstellar cop. Would the other cop types be jealous?
What? Jealous of the sorry cop? I think they'll be fine. Don't worry. They'll be super, super fine. It'll be totally okay. You can dual copo type from sorry to anything.
Fucking they should be sorry.
Yes, yes. Impotent rage and lamentation. let's wrap it up.
Yeah, I'm actually not sorry. I've changed my mind.
No, you don't. Come on. You'll be back to saying sorry in 2 minutes. Stop wasting time and begin the repentance.
I'm really not sorry. Fuck off. No. I'm not gonna be the fucking sorry cop. No. Bullshit.
Wow. Okay.
Fuck off.
Fuck off.
Uh-huh.
Maybe we were wrong about you then.
You are wrong about me.
Check out the big balls on fire cop.
Big balls on me, baby. Uh-huh. That's a fucking quick save.
There, he still is. Looking right through you.
How do I get this guy down? Kim? Any ideas?
Yes.
Tell me about
what
the
do
case.
You want to know?
He's not going to say anything. Okay. What's over here? In this dumpster looking thing? The letter R wears a crown on the ribbon below, a light above descending. Okay.
This trash container is locked. The sliding lid has a padlock that says, whirling in rags.
Why am I looking at you, trash container? You're just a trash container.
Just a trash container? There is no such thing.
Oh.
Your fingers start to itch just looking at that padlock.
How do we get the lock open?
We could try using a pry bar. The one you took from my motor carriage, or...
Did someone say pry bar?
Fuck yeah, pry bar.
Pry bar, pry bar. Your palms yearn its cold touch to grasp it once more, as you've done so many times.
No ore, pry bar.
We might want to ask for a key from the manager of the Whirling in Rags. He probably has one. And he also has information.
Ask the manager? Bullshit. Go straight for the pry bar and pry this baby wide open.
Three. Tool not equipped. Damn it. Hold on. How do I put this in my hands? There it is. Held right. Held left. That'll do it. There we go. Lock containers in the world? Actually, that could be both. Well, no. I need the torch more. That'll work.
This trash container is locked. The sliding lid.
What if I do both? Actually, wait a minute. What if I do it like this?
This trash container is locked. The sliding lid
20%
has a padlock that says, fourth time isn't happening. You've jammed the pry bar under the lid, but it just isn't bending. What is this? Your triceps ache for the metal to bend, but it resists. This calls for a potent curse to help break its resistance. Utter the power words.
The fuck kind of metal is this? This is fucking shit!
The quality of metal is not the problem. From what I see, it's sturdy enough.
Hang from the pry bar with all your might.
There's a creaking sound as the pry bar slips under the lid. You hang from it like a moron, huffing and puffing. Clearly the technique is wrong, but nothing else comes to mind.
Kick the container.
Unsatisfying. Hurtful. You hear a ringing sound, but not quite hollow. The can seems to be full. Full of itself. Mm-hmm. Content. Happy you failed. This snickering trash container is having a grand old time.
This motherfucker, I can't pry it
open. Let's ask the manager for the key. This is clearly not working.
I wanted to use the pry bar. I feel like I'm losing out on something not using the pry bar. Oh, goddammit. Son of a bitch!
Despair creeps into you.
I'm bad at this
game.
Getting
fat on your weakness.
God damn it.
You're still coming up with sentences.
Yes, it can be difficult to be on the receiving end of so-
Nothing you can say. Cop gives up the-
Fuck. I am losing it big time. Holy shit. Alright, maybe we should look around here first, see what else is there. Yeah, I'll take all that shit, sure. I will equip you. That should help us out a little bit.
An inconspicuous pile of the roofing material, Eternite.
What is this?
It's nothing. Someone just left some roofing material slanted against an old shack.
Why am I looking at this piece of the roofing material?
Because it's nice and orderly. Well-laid pallets. Easy on the eyes.
Okay. I don't trust it, but okay. Sure. Whatever you say. Winch mechanism has been oxidizing for some years. Neato. Whoa, yeah, wait a minute. Okay. That's danger. I really can't do anything about you, can I?
There, he still is.
No. Okay. Nothing else back here? You're really gonna make me run all the way around? Jesus.
There are several footprints in the mud.
Oh.
Left by work boots. Anywhere from 6 to 12 pairs have walked here.
What kind of boots?
Heavy workers' boots with reinforced toes and hobnails all over the yard.
Get an exact count.
What do you think you are? A super detective? You're hungover. These are just dents in the mud. No pattern emerges for the time being.
Fine, okay. Let's see then. What could we do? That one I did. Ooh, the abandoned gym, actually. Which I need you on for. And I haven't talked to you at all.
Hello, sir. Step right in. The store is open.
I am the law.
I know, sir.
Mm.
Are you interested in a new and exciting book?
What kind of store is this anyway?
It's a bookstore, sir. We sell books, postcards, and some board games. It's called Crime, Romance, and Biographies of Famous People.
Hmm.
Whoa. Hold your horses, little girl.
What is a book?
That is a book. They have stories inside them. It's like someone told you a story in a really long letter.
What's a postcard?
A postcard is a small cardboard picture. You can write a few words on the other side and send it to your friend or beloved.
What's a board game?
Board games are like little games on a table, made to pass the time. There are several different ones, but sailors here mostly buy cards.
Interesting, thanks.
My pleasure. Anything else you'd like to know?
Is it okay if I ask you some questions?
Okay, sir. I'll try to answer any questions you have. I hope they're about books.
What's your name?
My name is Annette, sir. My mum, her name is Plaisance. She owns the store. She's inside, minding the register, or organizing the stock.
The girl gazes at the window, then suddenly jolts her eyes wide as if recalling something.
Feel free to step in and browse our wares.
And you're out here standing in the cold because...
I'm signalling that the store is open. Otherwise people might not know. They'd miss out on the crime, romance, and biographies of famous people.
Such a good trooper, you already learned to value the work. I should have a word with the store owner, maybe?
Oh no, sir. I'm happy to help Mum by luring in customers. Besides, I have some hot juice in my vacuum bottle to keep warm.
Shouldn't you be at school or something?
I do my studies at home at the moment. I have to help Mum keep this place running.
Isn't going to school more important than this?
Mum says it's necessary to do both, because it builds character. Mum says a proper worker is dutiful. That's how you get ahead in life. You succeed.
There is stress and unease behind these words. She's reciting etiquette.
How's the business going?
Mom says it's peachy. She was a little afraid at first. There's talk about this house being cursed.
Oh, what way?
Cursed in the way that makes them say that no business has ever really thrived here, sir. That they all go...
ass up.
I wouldn't really say it like that, but I guess so.
I don't think curses are real.
They shouldn't be, but they seem real. Anyhow, they say that these grounds are doomed for businesses.
They're not doomed, but your mother should learn from their mistakes.
Of course, sir.
What is this crime business?
Crime fiction is about murders or burglaries or things like that, and the work of a policeman or a private detective who's trying to solve a crime and catch the criminals.
Wait, not crime fiction. I need to know what crime is. It's that bad.
Crime is a deviation from the law, punishable by either a civil or criminal sentencing. It's what the law prevents.
My brain no work that good at all. Why would anyone want to read about crime?
It's exciting to people, I guess. They get to imagine dangerous things, and it's kind of like a puzzle, where you can guess who the criminal is, or how the good guys are going to catch him.
I'm a policeman myself, by the way. The law, as I said.
You don't look much like a policeman.
What does a cop look like then?
Didn't mean to offend, sir. Sorry, sir. It's just that you don't look like Dick Mullen.
She points to a book cover on which you see a strapping Vespertine officer. He stands grimly over the body of a dead woman. Let's see. Used to be exactly like that Molly guy. Oh, excuse me. Nobody actually looks like the guy in the picture. It's just a stupid fantasy of man. Yeah, he's too hot. He's too hot. Not like me. I'm real. It's not your body. It's important your police work anyway. It's your... you know. Look at that. I'll never be as good as Mold.
Don't say that. He's not even real. You're real.
Overshadowed by a fake man? That's harsh.
Cheer up, sir. It's much easier being a fictional character. He doesn't have to deal with real things. Maybe you can show me some real deductive police work, sir. Like in the books.
Ooh. I'm gonna deduce something now.
The girl keeps her hands folded, hidden. Why is that?
Hey, why do you keep your hands folded?
What do you mean, sir?
You don't need to be worried. I'm here to help.
She looks around anxiously. Her hands remain folded in front of her. She doesn't want to show them.
If this mom is beating up her child...
The lieutenant stands by, looking at the two of you with little interest.
That's okay.
She brings out her reddened hands, her nails frayed, nearly chewed down to the flesh.
You bite your nails.
And you knew this from me keeping my hands folded?
Yes.
Well, that proves nothing. Anyone could do an easy deduction like that.
You think so? Fine, do better. Bet I can figure out why you bite your nails. This one might fuck my brain up. I would do this one.
She nods, half provocative, half enthusiastic.
Rats have been nibbling on your fingers. You're recycling your money material. No, it's just that person's sacrifice. You're uptight because of your mother and the pressure she's putting on you.
Maybe so, sir. Okay, I know it's a bad habit, and I shouldn't.
Either way, another ace deduction by the number one detective in town.
It was okay, sir.
There's more that can be achieved here. Ask her to do the same.
To do something about me. Fuck it, let's do it.
You're quite sober.
The lieutenant does not flinch at the comment. He does not flinch even a single bit. He is intensely not flinching. It takes effort.
And having a great time. How do you know I'm usually not?
Because you usually aren't.
Yeah, about that. Maybe you could point me towards some booze?
Fritz, maybe? Alcohol is not good for you, sir.
Fucking livers regenerate.
There she stands, swaying on her feet, assaulted by the early spring breeze. She smiles at you. The whole situation suddenly feels familiar, somehow.
I'm gonna breakthrough. Do I have anti-object task force? Breakthrough imminent. I don't know if that means I have that or I'm about to get it. Maybe after this conversation. What is romance?
It's the type of book where there's a rich lady and she has to choose between the good man and the bad man.
She smiles at the thought, perhaps imagining herself in that situation.
Or there could be a story about a poor lady getting a rich man. It's about man and lady business, sir.
What about a poor man getting a rich lady?
It happens, but usually the guy gets rich in the process. Or should actually be rich himself, but has lost his family property unjustly, like during the revolution or something.
Mm-hmm, I see.
Those are unhappy books, for most of the pages. People sad about what they have lost, but then it all turns out just fine in the end.
What about when both of the men are bad?
These are not very common. You can't have a choice between bad and bad. Nobody wants to read a story like that.
What if it's written really well?
Well, maybe then it's fine. Maybe if the lady then decides not to pick either, because she doesn't need a bad man. Yes, that would be interesting.
That's feminism. Let's do it. What about when everyone is poor?
That's really not a proper romance story. That's more like everyday life.
Sometimes you have to write about real life things.
Not in romance books, sir. These are about nice and pretty people, and everyone is happy in the end.
Not much of a reason to read them then, if you know exactly how they're gonna be. What about a book where the man and lady business doesn't work out at all?
I haven't read many of those. Maybe you should ask Mom.
You think she has one about an excruciatingly painful breakup?
I don't think it's a romance story if the main characters break up, though.
No, think about it. One where they plunge into a torrid spiral of pain and recrimination. Only it's really long and drawn out. Scarred for life. Phantom limb.
No, I don't know.
You can take this. Blossom like a pain flower.
Yeah. And it drags on for years and years with no resolution in sight.
The girl is at a loss for words.
Each of you filling with resentment and bitterness for having ruined each other's lives.
She shifts and sways on her feet, looking confused and uncomfortable.
Each of you tearing at the other's innards, leaving a gaping emptiness, a vacuum heart that still hurts ceaselessly. Fuck! God damn it!
Despair creeps into you, getting fat on your weakness. Whatever noble you're still coming up with sentences. He watches you melt down stoically from behind. Nothing you can say. Cop gives up the detective.
God damn it. Yo, this guy's like really fucking harsh. Son of a bitch. Okay, fuck it, we go back. Oh, the quick save's all the way back here? Oh no. Okay. Alright, fine. I want to explore that gym anyway. That's the area I want to be in right now. Here we go, get in there. Yep, fuck you, go in. All right. Hallway is blocked by old window panes and debris. Ooh, look at all this shit there is to see in here. A large demijohn full of strange liquid. Wild animals stare at you in the dark, stuffed and mounted. Okay. Airship rotors covered in spider webs, they remind you of blades. A naked mannequin torso, a strange yellow color. But where are the clothes it used to display? Money! Hell yeah. Blue velvet, soft to the touch, moth bitten. Okay. Steel rotor blades bearing a Slipstream logo. $50? Oh, hell yeah. Skis with Slipstream printed on the laminated top layer. More money. Good. Very good. Give me more things.
This appears to be some kind of machine with a cube-shaped heart and a wired framework. The keyboard has a rectangular on-off button. A piece of paper still hangs from the printer.
A radio computer. Just sitting here without anyone inside.
Sounds surprised and a bit cautious.
What he means is that these things cost money. Why would anyone just leave it behind? This is the Ream Civic radio computer, model RC5120, equipped with a Feld mainframe and a Ream-compatible printer.
You think I should turn it on?
We have one of these down at the station, but I never really learned how to use it.
Turn it on.
The machine lights up like some prehistoric animal stirring from its slumber, revealing fluorescent play and print keys on the keyboard. The hatch on the machine's central compartment is wide open.
Look inside.
It's empty, like a beehive without its brood. Some cables have been left dangling, disconnected. The filament you have would fit perfectly inside the compartment.
Yeah, do it.
Like a smooth draw, the filament slides into place. On the keyboard, the play key starts blinking.
Play.
A bar of fabric right above the keyboard starts producing a soft hum. The sound of static seeps through the machine's planar magnetic driver. Oh no. It was already glowing and now it's also making a sound.
Oh fuck.
It's probably some alien CO-like technology.
It might be.
The static gets louder, slowly filling up the abandoned hall, until a voice speaks out, crackling and old, cutting into the air.
Good afternoon. Fortress accident en rue de Saint-Ghislaine. This is East Insulindian Repeater Station, Please repeat. Is this the production schedule?
What's the production schedule?
The filament you have inserted into the reader.
You mean that glowing thing I put inside?
Yes. Is that the production schedule?
I don't know.
If you are unsure, could you please take a look?
How do I do that?
Open the hatch on the compartment. Don't touch the wires. A current is running through it, but the core is safe. There's a filament inside. I need to know what it's called.
It's called the production schedule.
Good. Please repeat the password.
This is the police.
I am contractually obliged to protect the privacy of the filament holder for trust accident. Without filing a warrant with Lintel, I cannot give you access to this filament.
I'm afraid we are not doing that, unless we want to wait for a month.
Now, can you please repeat the password?
Is it my birthday?
No.
Damn it. I'm really bad at passwords. Can you give me hints?
Still no.
I don't know it.
Received. I will register this login attempt.
That sounds bad. A login attempt. Something a criminal would do.
Fuck.
Don't worry. Passwords have a way of turning up sooner or later.
Fortress accident. Is there anything else I can do for you today?
Why did you call me Fortress Accident?
Fortress Accident is the company on whose name the terminal you are currently using has been registered to.
You have any other information about this company?
One moment.
You hear her flip through a catalog before she reads out with studious care.
Fortress Accident SCA produces revolutionary interactive calling radio games. That's what the catalog says.
And what's that, this interactive call-in radio game?
Any other questions?
Fuck. Are you a machine or are you alive?
Yes, I am alive. I am 74 years old and my name is Yvonne.
She repeats passwords. Programming people are all paranoid.
My partner says you're here because radio computer cast okay. Where are you? How'd you know where I am?
I work as a repeater at the East Intel Indian Repeater Station. It's my job to know where you are, Fortress Accident. As for me, well, I am sitting in my cubicle surrounded by a wall of radios.
On an island on the River Esperance, a small woman, all skin and bones, sits in a room filled with audio equipment. Thousands of tiny lights are reflected back from her prescription lenses, like stars in the dark.
Now, please tell me if there's
That's
a thank
all.
You and goodbye.
Tiles on the cube are still smoldering, casting the framework.
Prince.
Nothing happens.
Damn it. Leave. That's fine. I'm sure there's a password somewhere.
Your flashlight slides over an old green chalkboard covered in scribbles, sketches, and schemes like some ancient cave mural. Some of the writing has faded with age, but you can still make out sections here and there. Photos and drawings have been pinned to the board.
Inspect the drawings.
These lithe, pointy-eared creatures appear to be different types of welkins. You make out autumnal candle welkins casting wax-based magic.
Wax-based magic.
Translucent welkins, with organs shining under their skin, and even ether welkins, hailing from the vast emptiness of sidereal space. One of the welkins, towering among the rest, appears to be different, however.
Yeah, this one's important. Look at it.
It's Vara Hamira, a high welkin, his face white and scarred like cracked marble. This is clearly a welkin supremacist. The note says, all non-Welkin races will be purged.
Oh no.
The Haldor, the Tvorg, the humans, and even headless men, all of them, purged. Imagine a world filled only with Welkin. Green Welkin, Dread Welkin, and the High Welkin to rule them all.
An inordinate amount of time has gone into drawing these little Welkin creatures.
Oh boy. Wait. Oh god, did it soft lock on me? No, god damn it. No, please, I was enjoying that. Motherfucker. Might have. Son of a bitch, it might have. Ugh. Fuck, it totally did. Oh no, there we go. We're back. Let's see. Who are these creatures? Who drew them? Are they real? Nobody questions.
This looks like concept art for a project. It's not really real.
It's a supremacist.
Mm-hmm. Political commentary. That one has a great beard too.
Why would anyone spend so much time on this?
Some people really like building a world, I think. Even if it's just for a game.
This has been educational. Let's move on from the Welkins.
Just look at those details. So much effort.
The photo collage depicts barren, icy landscapes wrapped in perpetual night. You see permafrost and glacial landforms, dead trees groaning under the snow. Entire oceans have been frozen from shore to shore. There are pictures of settlements on dried-up riverbeds, abandoned in a storm. Animal corpses in the dark, carcasses and bones. Albeit dark and cold, this vision also feels cozy in its own way, like eggnog or morphine, a much-needed respite from our own world. A pinned postcard reads, "The heat death scenario, a desperate fight for geothermal energy engulfs the world as Wirral becomes untethered from its sun, drifting through the universe." This is a monthly calendar from the year 50. Cryptic words like sprint, daily minimi, and GPI span the marker-drawn grid, the grand scheme of production and money. It looks a bit like an academic calendar, only much more brutal.
Keep reading. What happens?
As time goes on, the numbers in the boxes grow rarer and rarer. The board becomes an empty snowfield in the final days. Only failure and regret dwell in this region.
Looks like they didn't make it.
A note in the bottom left corner of the chalkboard says, "See the prod schedule filament for details."
Ooh. Okay, we might get the passwords for that thing.
The handwriting is only partly legible, but you can still make out three slogans: "Call in, tune out," "Wirral untethered," and "Heat death of the universe." The full text reads, "Heat death of the universe is the new black." Another note says, "The biggest advancement in role-playing systems since the 30s. Outside, a cold wind wraps the building in its bosom. Snowflakes in the wind. An old woman passes what the locals call the doomed commercial area. She tries hard not to look at the bookstore windows. It's unwise.
Okay.
Anti-object task force.
Yeah, I did it. I'm an anti-object task force now.
Behold, the anti-object task force has assembled.
Yeah.
God's avenging angel arrayed against the lower emanations of the darkened one. Shoe racks, tape recorders, motor carriages, and doors. So many doors. You're not just pounding it all to pieces. You're reforging the universe.
Fuck yeah,
from the anvil of the heavens to the worms below. Indulge in it. Be bold. Have an impact on the shape of creation. Out of the furnace of your rage, a new reality. Also, you should trash your room again.
I should trash my room again. Attacking physical objects heals damage. I have thicker skin, all physically encapsulated by one. Fuck yeah, dude. That's quite nice. I like that. I like that a lot. Drop up all lieutenant's handkerchief. Okay. Yeah, alright. We can make it work, I think. There's more. There's this. What is this all about?
This old fireplace is covered in lines drawn in blue and red marker. The mesh spreading over the stone like blood vessels on alabaster skin. It looks ghostly and strangely ancient.
What am I looking at?
Radio frequencies, it seems. UKV 123.6. UKV 123.7. UKV 123.9. Some written notes, too. Sparse and cryptic.
Radio frequencies for what?
Unclear. It looks like a cardiovascular system split into veins and capillaries. Very advanced.
So we're dealing with something medical.
You think so? The web is comprised of radio stations. All lead back to one red heart, titled the Game Master Frequency. A note says, this one can listen in on any station it wants. Looks like a surveillance program.
Ooh.
They must have had massive air width. These things don't come cheap.
Who's the Game Master?
Someone very important. The leader of a massive on-air game built by these people.
If it's a game, then who's playing?
whoever decides to call in to a call-in station, it looks like. A list of names under the stations suggests people across six Isolas would be playing. Muindi, Insulinda, Kotla, Grad, Samara, and even Il Mara.
My God, it's as if the less money they had, the more ambitious their project became.
Cost of air with low must have been huge.
Exactly. This schedule, I know doom when I see it. The company was running out of funding.
What else?
Nothing. It's just lines on marble. An echo from times long gone. No one has used the fireplace in ages.
This game's good. Oh, hi. Kim, you scribbled across a notebook. Developers of the most advanced RPG in the universe. Oh, baby.
Okay. What do you think is going on with that computer, chalkboard, and fireplace?
Hi. Sorry, I'm just actually just getting really invested in the game there. Alright. Thank you, Captain. Appreciate it. Just cashing all that shit real quick. Alright then. I don't know how a stream chat's feeling about this game, but I'm actually getting like really invested in this world and all this shit, even if I keep dying because of mental damage. Oh boy. I'll check back in soon. Thank you. Appreciate it. If this is boring for chat, I'll understand. Honestly, this isn't like the usual shit I play on stream anyway. I get it. Looks like an undercover counterintelligence program.
No, that's not it. I think...
Like he's ready to lay out a fine theory, crafted together like a puzzle box.
It looks like one of those popular pen and paper role-playing games. Only these people were trying to automate it, make it work on radio computers.
It's not the game for me, but you play what you like. I think, like, personally, this writing alone is fucking fantastic. It's A grade. And there's been enough crazy shit happening, at least the first stream I made of this, that like that whole entire first building in the first stream, holy shit, it was a fucking riot. It's a very Swiss game for sure. Yeah, this was a recommendation from, I might just keep playing this on my own time, to be honest. Like, yeah, I might just keep doing this on my own time. I'm enjoying it, but I don't think it's other than like the dumb shit, like how I just punched the kid earlier on. That was pretty cool. I like that part. That was neat. Or like how I tried to pick up a woman and I was very hungover at the time. That's, it has its moments. Yeah, it's got some dumb shit in it, but it's not, it, how do I put this? It doesn't have no context that your kid's yelling rape. Yeah. 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 Oh, God. Yeah, no, like, the writing alone is keeping me invested, but I understand it's a hard stream game. So I might just move over to something else after this. I don't actually have anything else ready, unfortunately. It's... Ooh. Actually, let me check what my options are. Because I really don't think I have anything else lined up. Maybe I have something else lined up. Came in last stream with someone saying bonus and all I could think of was RE5 mercenaries. No, I can't keep milking RE5. I'm probably going to, but I can't keep doing it. I milked that game so fucking often. Let me check something real quick. Do I have this? It's not a bad replacement, but eh. Hmm.
No, I'm looking over at my list. And none of... I don't really have anything else going, so... I might just keep this going on my own time. To be honest. Yeah. It's cool. A single bullet run of RE5. I mean... I have RE4 installed. I'm honestly down for a random run of RE4. I could do that. Yeah, I could randomize up RE4. Da boy, yeah, da boy, I could do that. Yeah, you know what? Fuck it. Let's do it. Why not? let me get through this conversation. Fuck it, we'll do it. Are they planning to do that?
Two call-in stations. None of the players have to be physically present. Anyone in the world can participate in the game, as long as they have a two-way radio.
That sounds really complicated for the 50s.
Then there's the Game Master frequency that listens in on the smaller call-in stations. I think that was supposed to coordinate the stories, functioning as a master of ceremonies of sorts.
His fascination has swept aside other concerns for the moment. He's a little hooked.
Mm.
Coordinating so many games would take a whole switchboard of people, possibly divided into sub-frequencies.
Has anyone done this before?
Not to my knowledge. They make automated games in Grad, Messina, Königstein. You know, places with industry. But I don't think anyone has attempted to create an inter-isolary game before. We just don't have the technology.
Hmm. This was a role-playing game.
Indeed. Those Welkins are a dead giveaway. Role-playing people love that stuff. The world looks like a modified version of the Wii World board game, with Hit Death thrown in.
What do you think happened to the company?
No idea. They stopped filling out the schedule on the chalkboard.
Wow.
Indeed, it's ambitious and untethered from reality, but...
They were insane when they thought it could do this. It was just a play of cheap money. The world is cold and lonely. This would keep you company. Let's finish it. Yeah, let's finish it. Let's make this game.
It's too late for that, I'm afraid. Okay, let's keep moving.
I would have made that game with Kim. That would have been cool. I would have liked that. Okay, actual save. Can you do that? Actual save? Please? Actual save. Here we go. Yeah, I think I'm gonna keep doing this on my own time. Honestly. Yeah. I think that's the real plan here. Alright, so tell you what. I gotta set this up real quick. Plus, I gotta do some other shit in the background. So, I'm gonna leave you guys with some shit in the background. And I will be back in a few.